Hi friends, let us come back to our Learn English through Stories program. Let us learn a new lesson today. I can take care of myself. It is also from 8th class textbook, page number 84. Let us go directly into the story. It's a story, you know. Once upon a time, there was a mother rat. Yes, there was a mother rat who wanted to get her young daughter married as soon as possible. The mother rat wanted to send her daughter in marriage as soon as possible. Yes, to the most powerful being that she could find. She wanted to send her daughter in marriage to the most powerful being, living being. That's all. That she could find. So she was in search of someone who is most powerful so that she could send her daughter in marriage. Yes, who is the most powerful being on earth? Who is the most powerful being on earth? Not earth, but earth. She asked herself. The mother rat asked herself, who is the most powerful being on earth? She asked herself. She saw the bright sun god traveling across the sky. Then she looked up the sun god traveling across the sky. You see, it is moving from rising in the east, slowly moving towards the west. Most powerful sun god. She saw the sun god moving from east to west. Okay. Surely all beings depend on the sun. Really? All the beings on this earth depends on him. He is the source of all energy, the sunlight. Yes, the sun god is the most powerful being on this earth. So she thought our sun god is the most powerful being on this earth. She asked sun god, are you the most powerful being on this earth? She asked, see, with the humility, humble, she asked, oh sun god, tell me, are you the most powerful being on this earth? He smiled and said, no, there is one greater than me to help the creatures. There is one who is greater than me, who is greater than me, who can help the other creatures. It is the rain. Yes, look at the rain. Rain is more powerful than me. Without the rain, no crop or tree would grow. Without the rain, no crop would grow, neither tree, neither any plant. Isn't it so? When the rain water goes into the earth, the seeds sleeping in the soil would come up. Isn't it so? Yes, so powerful. There would be no water on the earth without the rain. Without water, we cannot survive. So, rain provides us water. So, he is more powerful than me, says or said the sun god. Just then it began to rain. At this moment, there came a rain also. She thought, right, how wonderful the rain is. Right now, how wonderful the rain is. It makes the whole land green. Yes, the rain makes the entire land green. You see, it makes the rivers flow. It makes the rivers flow. Surely the rain god is the most powerful being on this earth. So she asked the rain god, are you the most powerful being on this earth? Oh, rain god, tell me, are you the most powerful being on this earth? He smiled. No. There is one greater than me to help the creatures. It is a mountain. Yes, look at the mountain. Without the mountain, there would be no protection for the creatures on this earth. Yes, the mountain is protecting all the creatures. Really, even the rain originates from forested mountains. Isn't it so? Really, without the mountain, creatures cannot be protected. Yes, okay. The mountain blocks the clouds. When the clouds move, the mountain blocks them and the cloud is changed into rain. Then the rain comes down. It is a mountain that causes a widespread rain. Yes, The mountain blows the clouds and lets the water flow safely for the people and all life in the valleys. In that way, the mountain protects the life, on the valleys. She looked around and saw the beautiful blue mountain. Then she thought, how big and strong the mountain is. It is so big, so strong, so powerful. Yes, it withstands all winds and storms, able to withstand, will protect. You see? The winds and the storms ready to withstand, defend it from. Even when the wind comes, the mountain can defend it. Okay, it protects the earth and its creatures. Surely the mountain god is the most powerful being on this earth. She asked the mountain god, are you the most powerful being on this earth? Oh mountain, tell me, are you the most powerful? He smiled and said, No. There is greater than me to help the creatures. It is a worm. She was shocked to find that a worm can help other creatures. It is not so. Without the worm, the earth would be hard and nothing would grow in the soil. The worms keep the soil fertile. Even the bacteria, virus, etc. They are all very important. Is it not so? Suppose there is no bacteria, what would happen? Degeneration. Okay, now? The decayed things will not disintegrate itself. Okay, now? As a result of that, all dead things will be remaining as it is. What a life it would be now. Even the minutest thing in the world is also important. First you saw sun, then you saw rain, then you saw mountain. Now the mountain says a worm is very important. See, look at everything is important. Even a bacteria is important, is it not so? Yes. Without bacteria, this disintegration will not take place. Many things are there, no time to discuss. So without the worm, the earth would be hard and nothing would grow in the soil. The worms keep the soil fertile. The earthworm is the greatest friend that living beings can have. The best friend for a living being is the earthworm, which keeps the soil fertile. So, and then she saw her daughter coming towards her. Anyhow, the rat did not go and ask the earthworm, are you the most powerful being on this earth? At this moment, she saw her daughter coming. She asked her mother, what are you doing? Oh mother, what are you doing? I am trying to find out one who is the most powerful being on earth is. I am trying to find out who is the most powerful being on this earth. Why? Asked the daughter. I want you to marry him. I want you to send in marriage. Okay. And be safe. If you are married to someone who is most powerful, you will be safe, I will be safe, we are safe forever. Yes. Okay. Why would I need to marry to be safe? Who told you that? See, why would I need to marry? To be safe, I don't need to be married. Mark the words. See, don't think that only by marriage I can be safe. Who told you that I would be safe by marrying someone so strong and powerful? To be safe, I need to know how to take care of myself. To be safe, I need to know how to take care of myself. I should not depend on somebody and expect that he would protect me. He would take care of me. Then I can be safe. No. To be safe, what should be done? To be safe, I need to know how to take care of myself. Only by taking care of oneself that one can be safe, one can be protected, not depending on anybody else, is the wise words of the daughter. You are small, mother said, you are small, you need protection, you must be protected, said the mother rat. Generally, we know the nature, the theory of nature or the law of nature is that in your childhood, you are taken care of by your parents. In your youth, you are taken care of by your husband or wife. In old age, you are taken care of by your children. There is a law of nature, isn't it so? But one should imagine that we should not depend on someone or somebody to take care of yourself. You must be able to protect yourself. That is the best way to take care of oneself. You are small, you need protection. The best protection is to be able to protect oneself. The best protection is to be able to protect oneself. Yes, said the daughter. To protect myself, I need to learn to be strong and work hard. In order to protect myself, I need to be strong and work hard. I must be strong. I must not depend on somebody to protect myself. Okay, na? To protect me. Okay, I need to protect myself. I must be strong. I must be powerful. For that, I should work hard. But why would you need to work? Why should you work? If you marry someone rich and powerful, people think like that. If you marry someone who is rich and powerful, he will support you. You can live with support of someone. Said the mother rat, who is rich and powerful, Amma? The daughter asked, Amma, who is rich and powerful? Asked the daughter, the truly powerful being is one who can take care of oneself and those she loves. The truly powerful is one who can take care of oneself. One must be able to take care of oneself and take care of those whom she loves. One is truly rich if one is rich in love. The true richness is one who is rich in love, one who can love everybody else. I want to be powerful myself, not depend on anybody else. I want to be powerful myself so that I can take care of myself and those that I love. So that I can take care of myself as well as I can take care of those whom I love. The mother rat was confused. Is it not right? In a way, right? No. She's right. The daughter is right. Why not? Why should we depend on someone? And imagine that she would protect me. No need. I can take care of myself. For that I must be strong and powerful. For that I must be working very hard also. Yes, what will you do? She asked. I will learn to stand on my feet. Means being independent. You must be independent yourself. Not be dependent on somebody. But you must be independent. Not depending on somebody. You must be independent. I will learn to stand on my own feet. I will find what to do that supports me and my family. For that I need to learn more about the world. I must learn more about the world. I must get education. Learn more about the world. And learn to live in it as a good creature, as a good citizen. We must learn to live in this world as a good citizens. Let me first learn to take care of myself. For that, first I must take care of myself. But don't you need help? Yes, from you, Amma. I need help from my mother. You, Amma, I need help from you. Not from the sun, neither from the mountain, neither from the rain, neither from a worm. I need help from my parents, my mother, my father, etc., etc. Not from somebody else. Okay, said the daughter. Help me support myself. So you should help me support myself. Let me support myself. You should help me for that. I am not interested in marrying anybody rich or powerful, which means I should not expect that I can get support, protection by marriage. I must protect myself. Depending on another person's power, position or prosperity does not promise peace and security in the long run. Depending on someone else does not give peace and prosperity in the long run. Means ultimately it won't stand for long. It may be for some time, not forever. You must be able to protect yourself that will last forever and forever. Up to the end of your life, that will be with you. Yes, in the long run is ultimately, finally, one has to depend on the power within oneself. You have a power within oneself. To seek the target in one's life, to attain, to achieve the target of your life, you must depend on the power within you. You are powerful within you. Your mind is so powerful. You must be able to find out the strength in you. You are powerful and you must find the strength in you. Once again, last line. One has to depend on the power within oneself the strength, the power within oneself to seek the target in one's life. So, what is the lesson we have learned? We should not depend on somebody, someone to protect, to get protection. But you must find the strength in you and be able to protect yourself. That is the lesson we have learned from the lesson, I can take care of myself. Thank you for watching. Meet you with another story. Thank you.